Aversion is just attachment to being separated from what you don't like. They're both attachments.
Right.
So they look differently if you're not looking at where their source is. But it really is that you want whatever's happening to be different. So, you know, like if it's something you desire, you want more of it. Or you want to make sure you guard it, you know, so you buy the whole carton of cigarettes and you never run out. And you're very aware when you're getting close, you know, I have to get a carton of cigarettes today so I don't run out. Now I'm like that with milk. So, you know, it's, you know, ridiculous. But this is what we do. We don't want to suffer at all. Not even a little bit. And this is one of the reasons we run away from dissatisfaction. You know, we won't just wait it out. We immediately want to fix it. Because we think that's how you get happy. You know, you just keep fixing your little dissatisfactions, or you keep feeding your pleasures, when in fact, it's just gonna change.
So is the answer then just to learn to live with dissatisfaction?
Yeah. To reduce craving and aversion. That's what patience is to sort of learn how to that. Ability to just, oh, there goes my mind again, thinking that happiness is out there somewhere. Or happiness is changing whatever I'm doing. Or happiness is da-da-da-da-da. And just letting the moment pass. Doesn't mean there's anything wrong with, you know, eating food you like. You know, stuff like that. It's not about there not eating food you don't like. It's just about watching what your mind is doing, understanding that thinking your happiness or your peace of mind can only exist by external things is not true. Yeah.
So is there any reason to not change the temperature?
Yes. The reason not to change the temperature is to practice tolerating the discomfort. Why would that be?
Train the mind.
Okay, that's one reason.
Because we won't be able to change everything.
Because we won't be able to change everything, correct.
Like the story of the shoes and the leather. You cannot put leather like
yes, we can't cover the earth with leather in order to protect our feet, so we might as well just wear shoes. So, but okay, what's another thing? So one thing is that we get more familiar with dissatisfaction. We learn to tolerate it. And that gives us more ability to handle whatever comes up.
But don't many Buddhists pursue discomfort for that very reason?
What's the other thing it does?
Is it to think of each moment as just a moment, another good or a bad moment, just the moment?
Okay, so let's break that into two parts, okay? So one is, you know, equanimity. All right, this is just a moment. The other part is, it's just a moment. You know, that one of the things of not going to change the temperature does is help you recognize that your dissatisfaction is impermanent. You will forget about it. Our happiness, or let's just say, our satisfaction actually isn't dependent on that. It will pass. Yeah.
I think that's a big one. If you can grasp that and you can get it as, you know, as parents or our relationships, it helps us to understand that our happiness does not depend on what someone else is doing that we may like or may have this aversion for, that we can back away from it, and it helps me a lot with that.
Yeah,
I'm not
well,
there
you,
yet, but it certainly helps.
It gives you choice of how to respond. But it, only once you practice it, only once you really recognize that it really will pass. The discomfort, the dissatisfaction really does pass. It's, you know, but we have, you know, that's why it's so helpful to look at what your mind is telling you and decide whether you want to believe it or not.